G'day, didgeridoo, smart person. My name's Dylan. I'm a physicist from the land down under. Grab a coffee, grab a chair, grab a Vegemite sandwich. Look, grab whatever you want, and let's talk some physics. So I keep getting some comments along the lines of, Dylan, you think you're so smart, you don't even wear your glasses right. They're referring to this, you know, not sitting over my ear properly. And that's simply because this bit isn't long enough. Like, I can't push that down. My head's a little bit big, and hats and glasses don't really ever fit. Funny story, but my head is actually like 4.5 standard deviations larger than the average male head, which is like 99.999% larger than the normal human head. Anyway, big head gang, let's watch some Rick and Morty.
Smidgens for broken defraculator.
That is multi-phase quantum resonator.
Well, does it defraculate?
No.
Then it's a broken defraculator.
Like you would even know dick about fraculation.
So, quantum resonator, that is kind of like a real thing. They're not exactly called that, but we definitely have resonators that take advantage of some quantum effects. And they're specifically being used for many things, but for especially quantum computing. So I have a friend who's actually involved in doing some research for some quantum computing stuff, and he's looking at coupling magnons to a resonator, a microwave resonator. And to sort of explain what all this means is very hard to do, but magnons are like these virtual particles it would just take too long to explain this. It would probably take 10 minutes. But it involves the spin of particles changing, and it creates this spin wave effect phenomenon. And the spin wave can be thought of as like a magnon, as like a particle moving through a material. And you can couple this wave phenomenon to a resonator. So this resonator, you put electromagnetic radiation into it in the form of microwaves, and you couple this magnon to to a microwave. And that's what a resonator does. It amplifies the radiation by coupling waves, essentially. And this could be eventually used for quantum computing, actually. It has to do with the transmission of quantum information. But anyway, I won't explain that too much further because it gets very complicated very quickly, and I'd have to explain many terms along the path of trying to explain that. But just know that these quantum resonators are kind of real things, and we're trying to use them to get quantum computing to work.
Yeah, Dad, why don't we do it together?
Yes.
You back the right horse on this one, son. We'll get out the crayons, brew some coffee, and knock this thing out in 2 or 3 days.
What is my purpose?
Pass the butter. Thank you.
Dad, I need a ride to work.
Maybe Rick can give you a ride. I'm helping Morty with science.
I'm busy.
Doing what?
Anything else?
What is my purpose?
You pass butter.
Oh my god.
Yeah, welcome to the club.
That's amazing. Yeah. You can relate to that little robot. So what do you guys think the purpose of life is? I think that's one of the reasons everybody gets into physics or math. Well, not so much math. A lot of people go into math just because they like puzzles and shit. But a lot of the time people get into things like physics because it gets at some of the really deep questions. What do you guys think the purpose of life is? What's the meaning of life? Me personally as well, I don't think there is any obvious purpose to this place, as far as I can tell. It seems pretty null of purpose, and trying to find one by looking or studying the laws of physics seems like a good place to look, doesn't it? But it's a bit of an exercise in futility. And I think Carl Sagan put it best when he said, "We're the custodians of life's meaning, and if you crave some cosmic purpose, then let us find ourselves a worthy goal." And to me, a worthy goal was learning as much as possible about this astonishing universe in my brief moment in the sun.
I remember the first time I saw her. I thought...
I should get her pregnant and then she'll have to marry me.
I beg your pardon, Rick. Inappropriate.
Sorry, please proceed with your story about banging my daughter in high school. I'm not sure you want to take romantic advice from this guy, Morty. His marriage is hanging from a thread.
My marriage is fine, thank you.
Jerry, it's your house. Whatever you say it is how it is, but I think a blind man could see that Beth is looking for the door. I barely have a reason to care, and even I notice.
Come on, Rick! Don't talk about my parents like that!
Listen, Morty, I hate to break it to you, but what people call love is just a chemical reaction that compels animals to breed. It hits hard, Morty, then it slowly fades, leaving you stranded in a failing marriage. I did it. Your parents are gonna do it. Break the cycle, Morty. Rise above. Focus on science.
Yeah, I hate to break it to you, but if you haven't realized that, that's pretty much the truth. Put pretty harshly to a teenager. But yeah, it's pretty clear that this thing we think of love is really just something that has everything on the body and everything in your mind, it has an evolutionary purpose. It's pretty clear why something like love would develop. It just, exactly like Rick said, it compels us to breed. But we are all human, and we're subject to the human condition. So if you want to lead a happy life, I'd highly suggest not taking Rick's advice and focusing on science, as I wanted to do when I was a teenager. It's kind of, to get the point across, I'll use the words of Carl Sagan again. For small creatures such as we, the vastness is only bearable through love. And yeah, that's couldn't be closer to the truth, to be honest. You know, if you're a curious person and you look into the deep mysteries of the universe, it's pretty hard to find any real purpose. It all seems like a big old accident. And you know, if you want to be able to be happy, you have to take advantage of the human condition. And that means enjoying things like love, you know, because it will make you feel happy. So yeah, embrace your humanity and take advantage of things like love. Definitely don't focus on science. When I was doing my physics undergrad, I was the exact same. I was like, no girls, I'm going to focus on science. And I rarely got out. But then I met my current girlfriend, and yeah, that all changed. I haven't mentioned her on this channel before, but yeah, I do have a girlfriend. And I might even get her in some videos at some point. She's a medical student, so maybe we can get her in on some episodes where there's, some medical stuff. So yeah, it may be true that love is just this thing that has developed through evolutionary biology and natural selection, but it doesn't mean it's not true that you won't be happier if you exploit, you know, this thing that you're capable of experiencing. So yeah, don't ignore the human condition. Embrace all of it, and that means, you know, experiencing love and being social, because if you go against all these things, yeah, you might run into some psychological problems.
I told you I want to file a declaration that Pluto is a planet. Well, then my son's going to fail a science class, and when that happens, I'm suing you first. Oh, I think I know what the A in NASA stands for.
Dad, what's your end game?
Ain't no game, sucka.
Why don't we just make the solar system with 8 planets? It's even easier.
Sure, sure. And why don't we just burn Galileo at the stake for saying the sun is round? Science isn't always easy, Morty.
They did burn someone along the... I think his name was Giordano Bruno, around the same time, for suggesting that the sun... The Earth orbited the sun, which was put forth by Copernicus. This Bruno guy just suggested that it was truth, and they burnt him at the stake.
During routine surveillance of your world, you really gave it to those guys at NASA.
I was, you know... Sometimes science is about conviction.
I'd like to introduce you to a few people that very much agree with you.
Oh, I...
Plutonians! Jerry Smith is a scientist from Earth, where he's creating a model of our solar system. Jerry, tell Pluto about your decision.
Pluto's a planet.
Pluto's a planet!
a dwarf planet. But if there were any Plutonians, we've recently discovered that Pluto's atmosphere is actually collapsing. It's got this thin atmosphere. And some recent studies have shown that it looks like it's collapsing. So hope Plutonians have, you know, some contingency plans.